007 is one of the most iconic movie characters of all time, of course, played by some of the Hollywood's best known stars. But away from the big screen, there are plenty of James Bonds in real life.
Yeah, sharing their name with a world famous spy has impacted their lives in ways you couldn't imagine, though. Now they're telling all with a new documentary about the other James Bonds. Sean Connery was the first to play the famous spy.
Your luck, Mr.
Bond. James Bond.
Since then, it's become a global phenomenon, with new stars taking on the 007 role.
Bond. Come back alive.
Now, the real James Bond are making their debut on the big screen, thanks to a documentary filmmaker who hunted down the everyday people who share the famous name, including one in jail, accused of murder.
Mr. James Bond is here.
Great.
Ready for the interview.
They'll never stop calling me 007. I still get that to this day.
Others are politicians and preachers.
I remember at school there were really cool kids who wanted me to be around them because I was James Bond.
But not everyone likes the notoriety it brings.
When I meet someone, I know this stupid joke is coming, whatever it is. There's gonna be one.
I don't know where James Bond went in that film. I don't know what car he was driving. I do know that Daniel Craig is blonde because everyone wants to tell me that.
And the film's director, Matthew Bauer, joins us now. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
How on earth did you cook up this?
I was actually a member of a Facebook group of people who had the same name as me, and we talked about things like, you know, who's got Matt Bauer at Gmail, who's got the Instagram handle of Matt Bauer, and I kind of went, what if you ask guys called James Bond the same question? And I jumped on Facebook and tried to send a message to these guys, and very quickly it became clear the problem, because I couldn't find them, because you're not allowed to join Facebook if your name is James Bond, and you're also very hard to Google, so these guys are actually these quite hidden people online, especially.
Are there a lot of them?
There's a surprising amount out there, yes. Bond is a very common name, and obviously if you're the Bonds and you're having a son, the idea is going to come up. So yeah, there are thousands of these guys around the world.
So you can't join Facebook, or it's just very hard.
Facebook says that you're using a fake name if you try
really?
And join. I'm sure if you tried to join as Tom Cruise, it would do the same thing. So all of my characters on Facebook are called like James Bond with three S's, or JB Bond, or Bond James. So I eventually figured out that metric and was able to find them then.
Jimmy, I reckon you'd take
there
Jimmy,
is a lot of Jimmy Bonds. Yes.
Tell us about some of these James Bonds, because one of them's in jail at the moment.
Yeah, we found one of them in prison, and we tried to have a kind of a diverse mix of characters. So one of them is a guy who's in prison, who's awaiting trial for murder. And, you know, it's quite serious for him. He says the police haven't targeted him just because he's black, but because he's actually a black guy called James Bond. And that's his contention, at least, yeah. And you'll have to see the film to see what happens with him.
Yeah.
Right. Is this going to make it easier for the James Bonds once this film comes out, or harder?
I would say yes. In fact, a lot of the characters in this film actually describe doing this film as kind of like a support group, because they finally got to meet each other, you know, and they finally actually got to speak. This is a very specific problem to have. And these guys finally got to meet someone else who had the same problem, and we actually brought them together both on Zoom and kind of in a support group setting to share their stories. And they understood things about each other which no one else could imagine.
Matthew, I love that you've done this, and I also love the fact that potentially you could go into other names as well, because it's brought up so many other connections that you've had in your own life as well. I know there is another Matthew Shirvington. He showed me his license one at the Easter show and said, I hate you, because people keep saying, are you the athlete? And he says, no, and whatever. It's so good to see you, and I love the idea. The Other Fellow, which is the name of the documentary, is going to make its premiere at the Melbourne Documentary Film Festival on July 26th. And I'm really looking forward to seeing it. Thanks for joining us.
Well, thanks a lot, guys.